special theory of relativity proposed by whom? Special theory, Einstein. Einstein is the one who proposed. Till now we were thinking mass doesn't change, but mass also changes when it is moving with the velocity of light. That is known as variation of mass and velocity. And developing those famous Einstein's equation, what was that equation? E is equal to mc square. E is equal to mc square. E is energy. So when bodies are moving at the velocity of light, then the energy, it is converted into energy as E is equal to mc square. That is known as mass energy equivalence. So before we derive that, let us consider a case of two bodies of mass m1 and m2 coming in opposite direction. They get collided, and when they get collided, they get stuck and move with a common velocity, isn't it? When they get collided, they either completely burn or move together in the same direction and taking the velocity of the higher body mass particle. This is when the body is moving and when the observer is in moving frame of reference. He can see that they are stuck and they are going. Okay? Or it comes to a stop. But for a person on the observer who is at stationary, who is on the ground, he cannot say that it has come to a stop. He thinks that it is moving. Together they are moving with a common velocity. You observe? Initially, before collision, there were two different bodies, our mass m1 and m2. They are moving in two opposite directions. After the collision, it appears as though it has come to a stop as far as a moving observer is concerned. But for an observer who is on the ground, it looks as though it is going together as a single mass with a common velocity. This is the problem. So now let us try to analyze this situation here. Once again, you have two frames of reference. Before collision, this is moving with the velocity u, this is moving with the velocity u prime. This is prime coordinates, this is unprime coordinates. Now what is happening after collision? They are together moving as a single mass with what velocity? A common velocity v. Now let us see how do you analyze this. Let a collision take place between the two particles m1 and m2 moving with velocities u, and the other one is minus u prime. So respectively. Then how do you write u1 as? If you write u dash, it is u minus v by 1 minus u dash. If you write u, it will be u prime plus v by 1 plus u prime v by 6 square. And similarly, u2 will be given by minus u dash plus v by under root this. U dash what? Under root 1 minus u dash v by 6 square. So now let us see after collision what is it that is happening. They coalesce and come to rest as observed by which frame? A moving frame. But according to S frame, what is happening? They are moving like this, m1 plus m2 into v. So let us apply conservation of, even in relative motion, there is a conservation of momentum and energy is taking place. So when a collision is taking place, we apply the laws of conservation principles of energy and momentum. Let us first apply the momentum conservation. So before collision, what is the total linear momentum? Linear momentum is what we are considering. For the first particle, it is m1 u1. For the second particle, it is m2 u2. After collision, what's happening? It's becoming a single mass of m1 plus m2 moving with what velocity? V. This is the equation. Now, from these previous equations, you can substitute u1 is equal to u dash plus v by this plus m2, u2 is minus u dash plus v by 1 minus u dash v by c square. And on to the right, you have m1 plus m2 to v. Is it clear? And just writing the values of what? U dash, u1 and u2 in terms of u dash. What is v? It is the velocity with which the frame is moving. U dash and minus u dash are the velocities with which the two bodies of mass m1 and m2 are moving in the opposite direction. Is it clear? So now let us see. Substituting these values, what am I doing? I am bringing this m1b on this side and m2b will be as it is. We are just trying to simplify. This is mathematical. So when you do this, this plus v minus v gets cancelled, and similarly minus v plus v also is getting cancelled on the right hand side, and what you get is this expression. M1 into this is equal to m2 into So finally, when you write m1 by m2 is 1 plus u dash v by c square by 1 minus u dash v by c square. This is the simplification that we are doing. Now, from this expression, first equation, we have u1 plus u dash plus v by this. When you square this, this is going to be square of this. Next, 1 minus of this. When you do 1 minus of this, it is 1 by 1 by c square of this expression. And this, when simplifying, these are all the steps of simplification. And you do this, finally, what you are getting is this expression. Similarly, this was 1 plus u dash v. Similarly, by doing this, 1 minus u dash v by c square, what you are getting is this expression. And this gets simplified to this. And substituting in m1 by m2 expression, what you are getting is 1 minus u2 square by c square by 1 minus u1 square by c square. Supposing in this expression, if one of the particles happens to be at rest, if m2 happens to be at rest, that means what is rest? u2 is 0, isn't it? So the particle is at rest, the initial velocity is 0. If you substitute u2 is equal to 0 and the other particle is moving with the velocity v, this will be 0 and this will be 1 minus v square by c square and this will be m1 by m2. m2 is now called as the rest mass. So can I write m is equal to, this is actually m1, if you represent it as m is equal to m0 by 1 minus v square by c square. Now what does it give you, this expression? The last expression shows you how the mass varies by. Till now we have seen length is varying, it's getting contracted, time is getting dilated, is increased, and mass varies as m is equal to m0 by root of 1 minus v square by c square. Once again, the approximation, v is very much less compared to c. So v square by c square is less compared to 1. Can you neglect that? V square by c square can be neglected in comparison with 1. So only when v square by c square is very much less, m is equal to m0. Otherwise, what is happening to m0? The rest mass, is it getting decreased or is it increased? It is getting decreased. 1 by 1 less than a value, 1 by 1 less than 1 value will be getting decreased. So what is it that we conclude? Mass is getting reduced means what? It is getting disintegrated. We see mass, radioactive substance, when you leave it on the open side, what happens? It goes on disintegrating. You calculate your half-life period. What is half-life period? Time taken to disintegrate into half its initial value. And you see it is getting evaporated. It is getting completely disappearing. It will be of the order of few seconds for all the radioactive particles. Because they are all moving with what velocity? The velocity of light. So this is how we say, and if V is neglected, we can conclude that E is also equal to m0 c square. If V is very much less, so V squared by c square, then C comes up, it will be just equal to m0 c square. So we will next conclude that the energy is, the disintegrating mass is converted into energy. Where do you apply this principle? Mass, when it is disintegrating, it is dissipating energy, it is giving out energy. When do you apply this principle?